Hey, Dean, how you doing? Thanks for coming on over here.
Not a problem.
Hey, we had a lot of fun the other day on the Fox 28 Golf Challenge.
Yeah, you guys are good.
Yeah, I'm still working on a lot of those pointers that you gave me.
Yep, stay down.
Take a look at this.
You sure you should be doing them in here, though?
Oh, no problem. I do this all the time. Oh, no. Did you ruin my ball?
From the heart of Michiana, it's the Night Shift. Please join us live tonight as we welcome from Fox 28 Sports, Dean Huppert. From WSBT News Talk 960, JT in the Morning. From the Northern Indiana Center for History, Maryilyn Tompson. And all night, the music of Kalamazoo Kenny. So now sit back, relax, get yourself a glass of water and do whatever it takes to make yourself comfortable. And welcome your favorite host boy, Jason Eric Mumaw.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome to the Night Shift. My name is Jason Eric Mumaw and we are coming at you live tonight and we have a great show. So everyone just settle down now and just think about what you did. That doesn't really make sense. No. Well, did you hear about this? TV Guide is planning on revamping their popular magazine. It will have more interviews with stars. The magazine will now be full size and each week it will feature a different centerfold of Larry King. I don't know. No good at all. Well, how many people have heard of computers? You guys heard of computers? Kind of a big fad recently. Well, did you hear about this in Japan? They are working on building the world's fastest computer, and they say it will be able to do 10 quadrillion calculations per second. Now, that's fast, although, like most computers, it'll still take about 10 minutes for it to start up, so seems to be the run of the mill. Well, speaking of television, did you hear about this? Oprah is planning on releasing a DVD of highlights from the past 20 years of her show. Now, you'll want to get it the first week it comes out. As a special promotion, with every DVD sold, you get a new car. So that's just, that's the way it works with her. I'm going to get mine, I think. Well, did you hear about this? Robin Williams has donated $80,000 to help fix a retaining wall near his San Francisco home. Now really, $80,000 sounds like a lot, but not for Robin. He spends around that much just on getting his back shaved. So, have you seen him? He's got it everywhere. Well, big news for NASA. They finally got the space shuttle launched this week. In fact, the space shuttle met up with the space station today. And the first thing the crew did when they got there, well, they used the restroom and got some Slim Jims and Slurpees, so. Oh no. And finally, did you hear about this sad news? A Croatian farmer was killed when a cow fell over on him. Yeah, it's sad, but hey, this time I'm on the cow side. You know, if you grab me like that, I'm going to fall over too. That's all I have to say. All right, well, we have a great show, and right over there to tell you all about it, the only man who can't wait for gangrene to set in, Mr. Kelsey Zembrin. Kelsey?
That's right, Jason. We've got a great show for you. And if you want to be part of our studio audience, make sure you give us a call or visit us online at WNIT.org to find out how. On tonight's show, Fox 28 Sports Director Dean Huppert, from WSBT News Talk 960, JT from JT in the Morning, and his wife Maryilyn Tompson from the Northern Indiana Center for History. And all night, the music of Kalamazoo Kenny and the Rhythm Rats.
Also, we're going to have Dean Huppert from Fox 28. He's a sports director over there. We just got to go out. If you saw it last night on Fox 28, me and Kelsey, they let us come on out and do the Fox Golf Challenge. And, you know, well, I'll be talking about that.
They probably had
that.
Some regrets afterwards.
Yeah. So we'll be showing a little bit of that. And yep. You had that nice shot.
That one nice
the
shot.
The one shot. And then also tonight on the show, this is a really good show. I might have to watch it. We have JT and Maryilyn Tompson on. JT from JT in the Morning, so he's going to be on out here. And Maryilyn, she's from the Northern Indiana Center for History, so she's going to be telling us what they're up to, what exhibits they have going on. So it's going to be a really good show, so you'll want to stick around. Now, Kelsey, you look so nice. You make people feel so great about the way they feel when they're around you. When you go to the mall, people just flock around you and want you to say hi to them.
Thanks, Jason, and you look so good today that it was hard for the studio audience to find their seat because they were just looking at you.
Not many people know this, but most talk show hosts, they scoot their chair up. What if I just did the show like this tonight?
That'd be all right.
Look at that. I better. They're applauding me sitting down like that. Well, you know, last week, we were doing the interview with Katie Cruz from U93.
Yep.
And the subject of Celine Dion was brought up, and I made a comment about the way Celine looks. I think she's beautiful from the front, but from the side, there she is, Celine from the front. Doesn't she look beautiful?
Yep.
Yeah, but I said from the side, her profile is a little bit different. Here we can prove it tonight. Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't that just ever so slightly from the side? I'm sorry, that's all right. Well, you know, we always have a great studio audience in
here. We do.
In the WNIT studios here. We got a great looking one tonight, don't we?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, in fact, if we can, let's try and get another shot of our studio audience again tonight. Let's see if we can look at them. Look at them. They're enjoying themselves.
Not even paying attention to the show.
No, they're just happy to be here.
Yep.
Well, they're going to, they stick around and sometimes they pay attention to the show. But, do you pay attention to the show?
We have a show going on?
Well, sometimes we do. Now, do you listen to the radio that much?
Yeah, of course I do.
Do you like listen to a lot of music and stuff?
No, I listen to talk radio.
Talk radio? Well, this is kind of like talk radio. I've been hearing this on late at night. There's like this love lady on that comes on and plays dedications for everybody.
Did you happen to record that?
Well, this one was just the audio portion.
Uh-huh.
So I did get a chance to do it, but I think her name's Delilah.
Oh,
After Dark or
something. Yeah, I've heard of her.
And she's always sending out. I think she finally has flipped her lid, though.
Oh.
Yeah, have you heard?
No.
Well, I caught it last night. It was late near the end of her show, and here's a portion of her show. Tell me if it's odd.
Welcome back to Delilah After Dark. We're going on to our next special caller. Are you there?
Hi, Delilah. Well, it's been a very bad week. I just found out that my husband of 20 years has recently been unfaithful.
That's great. You know, that is so nice this time of year. And for you tonight, I personally picked a very, very special song.
Me? I think it was just me. Was that a little odd?
Not sure how that fit.
A little odd or a little long? I don't know.
Yeah,
how long do we want to look at Delilah tonight? Yeah, well, she's a looker, though, isn't she? I like that, Delilah.
What?
We should get her on the show, shouldn't we?
Sure, yeah. I'll make the call.
Well, we've been doing this all summer. We've been doing, looking back at some of the stuff that we've been producing here at WNIT over the past 30 years in a segment we called Gem from the WNIT Archive.
Right, right.
Well, also on PBS, WNIT, we have the wonderful Lawrence Welk Show.
Right.
Yeah, it's been along with us. Tonight, we thought we would also take a look at a gem from the Lawrence Welk Show. Take a look.
But we'll look sweet upon the seat of a bicycle built for two.
Now, wait a second. We enjoyed that, but can we roll that again? Let's take a look. Look at this, Kelsey. Can we see? Yeah. Now look at that. How fast are they going?
They're on the highway, aren't they?
They got to be going like 60.
Her hair looks good.
Look at that. And the bike's just kind of float. Hey, and where are his hands at right now?
I don't know.
Look at his smile.
Keep him in view.
Yeah.
I've been looking for a shirt like that.
Well, there you go. That's it. Well, let's get rid of them now. We've had enough. There we go. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
They're flying down the freeway.
Yeah.
Man, that Lawrence Welk, they got some super bike over there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why it's so popular, you know.
Now, Kelsey, do you, you know, not every day, but usually about a couple times a week, I shave for the show to keep clean and everything like that. Now, do you use electric razor? What type of?
No, I use just a blade.
Blade and everything. Well, they kind of, have you seen that new one they have out that vibrates?
Yeah,
that, you know, well, they keep improving things to a point to where I just don't understand. Well, they had the vibrating one, that was fine, but now they've really souped it up, and they got a new product out for this new shaver, and it's just overboard. Take a look.
Are you still looking for the ultimate in a close shave? Look no further. Introducing the new Ultimate Mach 10. This breakthrough gives you more vibrating power than you'll ever need. Achieve a super close shave in half the time, every time. That's the new Mach 10 Ultimate Vibrating Razor. Please consult owner's manual as razor vibrating power may become hard to control and injury may occur.
Way too much. That's horrible.
Closer than a blade?
Yeah, that poor guy, he's doing the recliner workout.
Yeah.
And now he's got the razor blade.
Hey, national commercials, you know.
Yeah, he's famous. Yeah. You know, I think it's time for us to calm down a little bit here.
Okay.
You know, we did this last week. We get a lot of fan mail here at the show.
Right.
And last week was all from the mothers. They wanted to hear the Conway Twitty. We couldn't hear enough of Conway Twitty. Well, the fathers spoke up this week.
Did they?
Yes. And so apparently they like Dolly Parton. So tonight they want forcing me to do this. It's Jason lip sync some Dolly Parton. You know, it'd help if I learned the lyrics.
Yeah.
And it wouldn't be that bad if they weren't right here. All right. Well, now all you fathers, you can stop emailing everything. Here, let's check back in on the audience. Are they still over there? Are they paying attention now? Is the audience? No.
Look,
there's my dad. Look at him. No, there's your dad.
Yeah.
Who's he with there?
I don't know. Well, I have to ask.
I'm glad they're enjoying themselves. Well, they should start paying attention. It's a really good show. All right, well, you know, the summertime blockbuster movies, I think you saw The Fantastic Four.
Yep, that's pretty good.
Was it fantastic?
Yeah.
Pretty good, you know, and superheroes are just all over the place. You got the Spider-Man, they got the Batman out this year.
Yeah.
They got it all. And so tonight, did you know that there are some superheroes that just don't quite cut it sometimes?
Huh.
So tonight, I got a list of them here that we're going to look at some unpopular superheroes. All right, now this is the first one up here. We're going to start off slow. I think it's kind of slow. It's Sugar Smacks Man. He's unpopular because he fights crime with his unusual breakfast-scented urine. I don't know. That may be just me, but I hear that's a rumor when you eat certain breakfast cereals. Do you hear that, Tim?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Okay, next one up here is Booger Man. Look at him. He defeats the evildoers by shooting flaming boogers out his nose. Look at him. Look at that, the size of that thing. All right, and up next here we have Lard Man. He's unpopular because he weighs 700 pounds and he can't catch any crooks because he can't move. How about this one? Super Old Man. Now he proves that superheroes also have to grow up, but that still doesn't make him popular. Super Old Man fights crime with a super stinky gas that renders the bad guys useless. He's sad, too. I mean, you can be Super Old Man and still be happy, but I don't know. This one here is a little risque, they say. It's a skank girl. She has the ability to dress like a hooker and fight crime. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. That's just Paris Hilton. I'm sorry. My bad on that one. Yeah. And how about this one? I like this one. Super Baby, another hero that could really be popular because all babies are cute, but his special power makes him very unpopular. Super baby can poop at a distance up to 300 feet. Yeah. I don't know. And how about this one? This one's a favorite. A varicose vein Betty. I don't know how this works, but I can see why it is unpopular. Look at her. Varicose vein Betty fights crime by showing bad guys their veiny legs and grossing them out and causing them to turn themselves in. And finally, nobody liked varicose vein Betty. That was a popular one of mine. And Viagra Man. Here we go. You can maybe figure this one out, why he's unpopular. Think about it. An old guy, Viagra, and spandex, not the best combination. So there you go. That's our look at unpopular superhero. All righty. And make sure you send your email of your complaints to Kelsey Zumbrin here at the station. That'll work all right. And speaking of Kelsey, all summer we've been doing stuff outside. We've been doing stuff in the hallway. And the summertime is a season for love. So a lot of people get married in the summertime and a lot of wedding receptions. So we figured, why can't we have the fun? So tonight we're going to have hallway wedding reception activities. There we go, rituals. All righty. Now, Kelsey, you out there?
Yeah, we're out here.
Okay, the cops out there?
No, we got some great lights that are setting the mood, and our friends over at El Vegas were kind enough to let us use those to set the mood just right. They have all kinds of things over there, so stop in and check them out.
Right, so they're like the headquarters for you know, all things wedding reception.
Yeah, wedding reception, guitars, musical stuff, yeah, all kinds of stuff.
All right, now Kelsey, tonight what we're going to be doing is we're doing these wedding reception rituals. First up tonight, what is very typical at the wedding receptions? You always have the dollar dance.
Oh, yeah.
And now I see you got some fine-looking ladies out
there.
Yeah,
we got, yep.
And they got their dollar bills handy?
I think I'm supposed to pay them.
Oh, is that how, that's the twist on it tonight? You got to pay them to dance with it?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, Kelsey, we're gonna go to you. Can the girls hear me out there?
Can you hear? Barely, but yeah, we can hear you.
Okay, they look like they're excited out there.
Yep. Okay. Do we get any music for this?
I think so. If we can go ahead and fire some music so we can start the big dollar dance out there.
Okay, first up.
Here we go.
And this is, we're just going to kind of dance. And do you know anything? I learned the waltz.
Yeah,
you'll find out later.
Kelsey, loosen up a little bit. They're paying you a dollar to dance with.
Don't
you.
Don't get dizzy. What?
They're paying you a dollar. You got to loosen up.
Loosen up?
All right. Well, let's move on to the next one, Kels.
Okay, next. Do you know any
special? All right, here, we'll let him continue out there with the wedding reception rituals. So there he is. All righty. Well, we did have a lot of fun this week. Speaking of dancing, Kelsey should be pretty good at this. We got to go to the Dance the Night Away dance school in downtown Mishawaka, and we put Helena and Kim to the test. They're trying to teach us how to dance. So here, take a look. All right, Kelsey, today we're in Mishawaka. We're at Dance the Night Away. Now, I don't know how to dance that well, do you?
Not at all.
All right, well, we're going to go in and we're going to meet up with Helena and Kim.
Right.
And they're going to instruct us on how to become better dancers.
Or dancers.
Right, so let's go in and see what we can learn. All right, well, we're here with Helena from Dance the Night Away.
Mm-hmm.
Now, just looking at me, do you think I have the ultimate dancer physique?
Definitely.
You didn't even look at me though. You just looked right at me. Oh, you checked me out when I came in?
Exactly.
You're like,
we always do.
You sized me up and we're like,
yeah.
He's a dancer. Before we start anything, uh-huh. You like to see the person's raw material. Now, this is all self-taught.
Okay.
Is there anything in there? Really?
Yeah.
Now, what did you see in that?
I think some ballet classes might be good.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, should you stretch before?
It's a good idea to stretch before, especially when it's cold outside.
One problem I have, every time I stretch, I moan a lot. Is that all right?
Yeah, as long as you're quiet about it. Yeah.
Okay, Kim, you're stuck with me. Jason somehow roped me into this. I just want to let you know up front, I have two left thumbs. I'll take my shoes off to prove it. What are we going to learn first?
We're going to learn cha-cha. We're going to start with our left foot. You're going to go off to the side, okay? Then back, rock, and then forward.
Good.
All right, now when you look at me, you think tango, don't you?
Yeah, definitely.
Can Could you show us that, how it's supposed to look, though?
Sure, Kim.
Now in Argentina, do they ever dance around the people?
Jason showed some stuff that he could do, so maybe I could show you.
I would love to see.
I don't know what the name of it for, but it was something like that.
That looks like it hurts.
I think if you were good, cool. You're supposed to jump back.
Oh.
What's next?
You know how to do the robot?
Okay,
we'll do it together.
Now.
Ready?
Okay.
It's left first. Always, left first. Always left first.
Okay.
Ready?
Is there a reason for that?
No.
Oh, okay.
Really.
Okay.
One, two, three, four. And you gotta make the face.
Okay. Now, we're gonna try what's called a gancho.
Okay.
Okay? So I'm gonna do the foot kiss. You're gonna stop me, and I'm gonna come back and gancho you.
Wow.
Okay, and you just
so basically kick me.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. That's a nice word for kick.
Just a good old boy, never meaning no harm. Beats all you never saw, been in trouble with the law since the day they was born.
When you ask somebody to dance, like say there's a lady over there you want to ask to dance.
A fine looking lady?
A fine looking lady, yeah.
Right.
You go over and you present your hand and say, may I have this dance or would you care to dance?
Right.
Yeah.
So there's just a couple things you don't want to be doing one of these if you're a guy.
No, no.
No, that's good, you'll get slapped.
Right, and it's the lady's decision as to how close she gets to you.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So what if the guy's uncomfortable then?
Well,
do you just push her away?
That would work.
You would never shove her on the floor.
No, that's probably not a good idea.
So now me and Kelsey, he had his training, right?
Mm-hmm.
I had my training.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to bring it all together in the
okay.
in the big finale.
Okay.
Through that door, baby, when you beat me for life, you gonna make me so. If you don't greet me right, don't you ever kiss me once, kiss me twice, but leave me nice. I know that you've been told that better keeps my life.
Very special thanks for the Dance the Night Away, all the people over there. If you want to get some really top quality dance lessons, they really know what they're doing over there, so we wanted to say thanks to them. But my first guest is the sports director of Fox 28 WSJV. Please welcome to the show, Dean Huppert. Dean? All righty, thanks for coming out. There it is, isn't it?
I brought it back.
All right, now not
it's dry.
Not many people, well, did you get a big response from that last night?
I got a big response from my boss when he called and said, the microphone went in the water.
Right.
And all I was trying to do is get a shot of you guys coming across the bridge.
I know, but see, that makes a memory, doesn't it?
Yeah,
you'll
it
always remember that, right?
Yeah.
And if you drop the
and
thing
I made
the
a first impression, didn't I?
That's right. No, that's pretty. So this is the actual one. It's still drying out there.
It's there.
All right. Well, Dean, you're the first guest on the show tonight. And if you've never seen the show, do you know what's coming up? It's Would You Rather.
That was a little nervous.
That's me singing.
About this, yeah.
Okay, here we go. Would you rather have bottles stuck on all your fingers on one hand for a year? So bottles all over your finger. Or have a bucket stuck on your foot for 1 year. So you gotta have bottles on your hand for 1 year or a bucket stuck on your foot for 1 year.
I think I'd go with a bucket.
Really?
Yeah.
I think so too. You so much stuff, you type in and things like that, but you know, I think that'd be the more comfortable one for the year.
And plus, you think about running, you can stay in shape, you got a bucket on there,
that's
you're gonna
right.
have to run a lot
harder. You'll have
right?
a huge one leg after
yeah,
a year,
you can fill you? It up with water when you get stronger.
That's right. Well, how's your summer going, Dean?
Having a great summer, man. Playing some golf, getting out to some baseball games. Just went to a White Sox game over the weekend.
Yeah.
Doing a little work, but yeah, it's been a fun summer. Can't believe it's almost over already.
Oh, I know.
Yeah, thinking about the high school season, Notre Dame, everything's just starting to.
Yeah. Now, how does that work for you guys there? Now, you guys are huge on high school sports.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about, I was thinking about this earlier. What sport category has the most passion? You got your professional sports, you have your college sports, and you have your high school sports.
Yeah.
I would tend to think it's probably more high school, college. They're fired up more.
I think for our station on Friday nights, it's all high school. When you're talking about high school basketball in the winter or high school football, it's kind of funny because I hear people say, yeah, we got to really go all out for football. And then it's like, well, this is Indiana, Michigan, you know,
right.
This is basketball. So we got to go really from August all the way through March, and we're hitting it hard. And then, of course, there's that thing on Saturdays that Notre Dame Stadium seems to get over 80,000 people out there.
People show up.
Yeah. So and there's a lot of excitement about that this year, too. So
right.
I think we're in a really great time with our high school sports, plus Charlie Weiss and the new Notre Dame team.
Well, jumping back to high school just for a quick second here, who's looking good this year, especially for football coming up in the fall?
Well, Media Day starts tomorrow, so everybody's looking great.
That's right.
They're all going, oh, yeah, you know, this is going to be the year we're going to get over the
sure.
hump, and all the cliches will come out. You know, the kids are going to give 110%, and,
right.
you know, we're going to take it one game at a time, so that'll be a lot of fun.
So now moving on to college, though, this is Charlie Weiss, Coach Weiss's first mm-hmm. season with the Irish, and, I mean, there's always huge expectations for all these coaches when they come in, and Willingham, he had the great season that first mm-hmm. year, but that probably wasn't the best thing for him. How do you think, Wise, what's he going to do?
It's kind of funny because I've heard people say, well, he's got the same record as George O'Leary at this point.
That's true.
And there's so much hype right now for Charlie Weiss. It's
right.
like, oh, you know, he's won these Super Bowls. He's done so much. He's a Notre Dame guy. And he has recruited. I mean, the guys that he has coming, they're going to be good next year, but the guys he has this year, it'll be interesting because the entire offense is back. You've got Brady Quinn, you've got sure. Darius Walker. Everybody's back on offense, all the receivers. It's going to be the defense, the question mark.
Right.
And he didn't set the schedule, and four of the first five games this year are on the road.
Oh.
And then they've got a bye before USC. So if you start out with Pittsburgh, then Michigan, then you got Michigan State at home, Washington, and then Purdue. If you can do well in the first five games, especially when four of them are on the road,
right.
you've got USC and a slew of games coming at home, so that'll be nice. So.
Yeah, it'll be an interesting season to watch. I think everybody's kind of yeah. really got the high hopes, but I think he just looks tough, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
He's got pretty intimidating.
Got that
yeah.
football yeah. look, and he's like, you know, college football pressure. Talk right. about being on the Super Bowl and everybody's
exactly.
watching. I think Janet Jackson found out what pressure was there. You know, it's like
just a little bit.
People
yeah.
know what pressure is, and it's every move you make is going to be scrutinized.
Now, you guys have been doing this. How long have you guys been doing the golf challenge over there on Fox?
We started in 1991.
Right.
A guy named Mitch Roberts, who did a lot of great things here for local sports. He and I started, and we started playing against each other. And we found out we looked really stupid playing against each other because we had to show all our bad shots, and then we'd get mad at each other because we were competitive. And so we decided a couple years later when Rick Shutt got here to team up, and it's been awesome because now we're a team. And Allison Hayes and I are a team, and we're playing you guys. And, of course, I duff my second shot, and Allie puts it on the green, and we're all good.
It was a lot of fun, though. Now, we brought some clips. We had our camera guy out there. In mm-hmm. fact, the guy that actually, Tim, you remember this, don't you?
Yeah. You the man.
He's the one that went
he
in and
fished it out of the
he
water.
He did, too. Yeah.
And he set the camera down. He was so cool about
right.
that because I'm like, good. They don't have a shot of me
right.
dropping it in the water because
that's
he
right.
set the camera down.
Well, we do have some clips from the golf challenge that we took mm-hmm. on. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. We'll talk through this and just see. There you are. And that's on the hole we actually played, right? Wow, look at that sound.
I didn't hear that out there.
All right.
Yeah, clip the tree, stay in.
That was an awesome drive.
Oh, yeah.
Here's me. Look at that. That's Kelsey, he's off into the trees. What do you think of my swing?
It's interesting.
Yeah.
Your swing's not bad. It's when you hit the ball in the water.
That's right.
It's bad. Now, you guys were a lot of fun to play with because it's hitting
right.
the ball. We're going up there. You still had a smile on your face the whole time.
That's when Kelsey about took your head off.
Yeah, I pounded it there. You didn't see me diving behind Allison on that one, did you?
There it was. You guys still beat us by the one stroke.
Funny thing is, I looked at the scorecard there, and Kelsey put a two down.
Yeah, he he's known for doing that. And then here's Allison's shot to bookend it. No, that was a lot of fun. We appreciate you. So you guys been, we got to do that, but like, what other people get to do that?
We've had people through the years. We had Gail Sayers on one time. We've had Mayors, former Notre Dame players, Ross Browner. I mean, there's so many great people this year. Muffet McGraw.
Oh, yeah.
we've never beaten Muffet McGraw. She goes out there and she'll hack it around, and she's a really good player, but she's just all relaxed. She's talking. All of a sudden, the camera gets on her.
Really?
She gets intense. It's just like a Final Four, and here she comes at us.
Pretty intimidating, huh?
Yeah, she really is.
Are you guys still doing this at the Dino Awards?
We do it during the school year on Monday nights, yeah.
And what is that exactly?
It's, well, we have a panel of judges that come in. I mean, there's 8 to 10 judges each week, really dignitaries from across the world that fly in, and then they vote on the best plays.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, well, it's actually me looking at the best plays of the week, and then I actually put them on, yeah. So we try to get a lot of local stuff, a lot of high school people on, and then we say they're judges and don't tell anybody, though.
All right, well, Dean, thank you very much for coming on here. I want to thank you again for letting us come on and do
the golf
challenge. You guys are on every night. You got the 9 o'clock news. You got to rush on over to do the news tonight, don't you?
Yeah, I think I got a little over an hour, and I'll be on tonight. So.
All righty. Well, we're going to get into the music here, and then I'll let you go. Our next guests are a great rhythm and blues band based in South Bend. They will be playing at the Firefighters Blues Festival in South Bend on July 30th. Please welcome back to the show Kalamazoo Kenny and the Rhythm Rats.
Up your boots and we'll groove on down to a knockout place down by the edge of town. There's a five-piece combo that just won't quit. Keep walking till you see the blue nightmare and fall in. Lord, see them sights down at the house of blue lights. There's fryers and broilers and Detroit barbecued ribs. But a treat of the treats is when they serve up them Friday feasts. You're gonna spend the rest of your life down at the house blue lights. Scoo-dop-a-dee-dee-bop-a-doo, scoo-dop-a-dee-dee-bop-a-doo. And we'll cut some rug while we dig them jams like they should be done. It's a real homecoming. All them cats just boogie on down across the tracks to fall in. Lord, see them sights down at the house of blue lights. There's fryers and broilers and Detroit barbecue ribs. But the treat of the treats is when they serve at them Friday feasts. You're gonna spend the rest of your life down at the house of blue light. Like they should be done. It's a real homecoming for all them cats. Just boogie on down across the tracks and fall in. Lord, see them sights down at the house of blue lights. There's fryers and broilers and Detroit barbecue ribs. But the treat of the treats is when they serve at them Friday feasts. You're gonna spend the rest of your life down at the house of blue lights. Come on, guys. House of blue lights. House of blue lights. House of blue lights. House of blue lights. Just bring it on down across the tracks back to the house of blue lights. One more time. House of blue lights. House of blue lights. House of blue lights. House of blue lights, just boogie on down across the track back to the house of blue lights.
Yeah. There they are, Kalamazoo, Kenny, and the Rhythm Rats are going to be back in a little bit doing another performance. So we're glad they're here. And it's kind of like we have the wedding band here playing tonight because we're doing the wedding reception rituals out in the hallway. Are we out there, Kels?
Yep, we're out here still.
All right, there he is. And you got the fancy lights. Did you liking those lighting effects?
Yeah, I'm liking those. I think we might have to tell El Vegas we're just not going to give them back.
Right.
They look good in our office.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. It can get you hypnotized.
Yeah, I'm just going to stare at them for a while, if you don't mind.
All right. Yeah, let's all stare at them. Get all those girls out there to stare at
the
lights.
Look at the lights.
Look at them. Okay, Cal.
Okay, yeah.
All right.
Something going on?
First segment we did, what did we do? We did the dollar dance. How'd that go?
I didn't make any money, but I lost about $5 or $6.
Did you?
Okay. Yeah.
Well, that's pretty good. Now, another typical thing we do at wedding receptions is the famous chicken dance. So I think you got some people out there. It
looks chicken like dance.
Yeah, so we're going to go ahead. We got some music for the chicken dance. Let's see you guys do the chicken dance.
Show me how to do it.
Yeah, there they are. Look at them. The riders really overexerted themselves this week. How long do you think we should let them do this?
I don't know. Is this good?
All right. Good job there.
It's better than my waltz, that's for sure.
All right. Thanks, Kelsey. We got one more time with him back out there in the hallway. We're doing wedding reception rituals. How great is that? Well, my next guest can be heard every morning on JT in the Morning on WSBT News Talk 960. And along with his wife from the Northern Indiana Center for History, please welcome to the show JT and Maryilyn Tompson. JT, I can see you're quite the gentleman. I noticed that she got to come out first. Was that planned? Say yes.
Yes, that was planned. Right. By the way, I love this chair. Can I have one like this for the studio?
Sure, if you want to.
Send it over, will you?
I will. In the morning, you wouldn't fall asleep in it or anything.
Well, you never know. It's very comfortable. I just might.
And I look at my chair. I get to sit in this little rinky-dink office chair. You guys, but everything for the guests, right?
Thank you so much. Yeah. By the way, I want to say, Jason, that for the longest time, I've had the ultimate respect for you until...
Until
I saw you wearing that Yankees cap in the dance sequence. You know, for someone who was born and raised in New England, that's like heresy.
I have to tell you, everybody, because I've been wearing baseball hats for a long time, and if anybody knows me, they'll come up and say, "Oh, you Yankees fan," and they'll ask me. I know nothing about the teams. Which, yeah, I have a Detroit hat, I got a Cleveland hat, I got a Yankees hat, so it's just however I feel that day.
Have to get you a Red Sox cap.
There we go. I'll wear it. I think they just, I just like the style of them.
That would be great.
All right, now, well, we asked Dean, and so we got to ask you guys, now, would you rather have the bottle stuck on your fingers or the bucket on your foot?
Go ahead, dear. You first.
I'll take the bucket on the foot. That way you can still grip a golf club.
That's true. Yeah, and then the bucket might even balance you out to give you a... And Maryilyn?
I'll take the shopping bag on my arm. Was that a choice?
I'll make it a choice. There, shopping bag, I'll take that too. There you go. I'm with you.
I'm with the bucket on the foot too, you know, because you want to talk, you want to use the computer.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I think that just makes a little bit more sense.
Yeah, I think so.
So now how long have you guys been married?
It'll be 5 years in December.
Really? I got some pictures here. You guys are serious about being happy here, aren't you? Look at this. Now where is this picture at? We get a shot of that one there.
That was taken on the beach in St. Joe, Michigan, and in fact, I don't think we were married yet at that point. I think that was just before the wedding.
Right.
There's some serious happy going on there, though.
That is some serious happy there. Or a new coat. We got this one here. Now, this one looks like...
I'm trying to take over for John in the studio there, but as you know, it doesn't work. So that was taken in his studio.
And this is the most recent one here. We'll get to one more here. Was just taken this year.
This was last year at my son's wedding, the night before.
Now, this picture was actually in color, right?
No, it was not.
It went to the black and white ball.
Oh,
no. No, that's horrible. No, so you guys have been married for 5 years.
Right?
Yes.
Very happy?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Ask us how we met.
How did you guys meet? That's a good question. You want to sit over here? I want to get in a comfortable chair.
We met in John's studio.
Oh, really?
As a matter of fact, I was a guest on his program. I was appearing on his program to talk about the Center for History, where I'm the marketing director. And I was very nervous because I know that John's been on the air for many years and that it's very serious business. But I came in that morning to talk about Christmas at Copcha Home. And he was so nice and thoughtful and made me feel very comfortable. And that's how we met.
Shortly after that, I was in Jacksonville, Florida with the Notre Dame marching band. I do the announcing for the marching band, and it was on New Year's Eve, and I called Maryilyn at 8 o'clock, and we talked until just after midnight. And I knew then that there was something, something special here.
Right. Now, JT, and I think you have this correct, you have the longest running morning show in this area. Now, how long have you actually been doing your JT in the Morning show?
Here in South Bend?
Yeah.
It'll be 30 years, January 1st.
Wow.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't set you up too much as far as, you know, but I think most people in this area know exactly who JT in the Morning is, so I didn't have to say that. But what got you into it?
Well, years ago, I was living in my home state of Massachusetts and trying to decide on a career, and I heard some of the guys having fun on the air in Boston, and I thought, you know, that sounds like fun. I think I could do that. So let's find a little bit more out about it, and I did, and I guess the rest is history. Started in southern New Hampshire and went from there to Worcester, Massachusetts, and from there to Colorado, from there to near Hershey, Pennsylvania, and for the past almost 30 years here in South Bend.
Now, I mean, I know a lot of radio people do the moving around type of thing, but what was it about this area that kept you here? I mean, 30 years is a long stay in radio, isn't it?
They told me that in 2005 there was going to be this TV show called Night Shift. And have a chance to be a guest.
Oh, wow.
I knew if I waited long enough.
Who told you that? That's pretty amazing. Yeah.
That is amazing.
Now, you had me on this morning on your morning show. I have to tell you, I'm more nervous doing stuff like that than I am doing any of this kind of stuff.
Oh, that was piece of cake. He was great. He was terrific. We did a little phone interview and a reminder of what was coming up tonight on the show, and it was fun.
Yeah, oh, I had a blast, but I'm sitting down because I have where I do all the stuff for the show. I'm sitting there, and you call the people, so I'm sitting there waiting for the phone. I'm like getting everything ready. What am I going to say? JT, okay, 30 years, and show tonight and everything like that. So I don't know how you do that every morning. I mean, you got to get up pretty early, don't you?
The first alarm goes off at 3:30.
And then the snooze for 4 or 5 times?
Yeah, but when I retire, whenever that is, I think I'm going to put that alarm clock on a fence post and get a shotgun and boom, you know, give it a good one.
Right. Now, Maryilyn, you, like you said, you are the marketing,
director.
At the Northern Indiana Center for History.
That's
how long have you been doing that?
I've been there for 7 years, and it's fabulous. I love history, and I don't think there's anything better than being able to tell people about history and what we do and help them to feel excited about coming and visiting our exhibits. And this summer, we have something for everyone. We have an exhibit on cockpits. It's called At the Controls. The Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum looks at cockpits, and it's traveling. We're so excited. And then we also have a 1920s costume exhibit in the Oliver Mansion. And then we also have Shakespeare on stage. And that's in partnership with Notre Dame's Summer Shakespeare Program. So it's a fabulous institution. I love working there.
Right. And a lot of people should just come on out because, it's our local history and it's real close.
You should come.
I should come.
Yeah, I would love
I've been there for the station before.
Oh.
And we did a thing where I had to pick up some old footage that you guys supplied for.
That's right.
Let's say somebody has something that in their basement, they're like, I don't know whether or not this is something that's worth anything. Should they just call you guys?
Yes.
You guys get a lot of that?
We do. We get phone calls or people who come in and they say, I found this in the attic, or I this is an old photograph, and can you tell me how to help preserve it? And we're happy to talk to people about that kind of thing because we want them to save their history as well as in that way we can save our community's history. Right. So it's great.
Yeah, I think just as you get older and older, history just comes alive, I think. I don't know what it is. I think some people get it when they're a kid. But for me, I just, eating everything up, the World War II era, I just love that, the 50s and stuff like that. So I think that's really neat.
I was just going to ask you, what is your favorite era in
history? Probably late 40s, 50s, coming out of the World War II. And then I'm a huge Elvis fan, so I love all that. I've been down to Graceland to do the Sun studio tour and things like that. So it's great.
Now, that's too funny, because last year we had an exhibit on World War II, of course, because we were celebrating the 60th anniversary of D D-Day, and then this past winter we had an exhibit on Elvis Presley. So you see, we're just for you.
I should have came over and did a segment there.
You should.
I could have danced in the.
Listen, we'll have you over, and you, okay. And you can show everybody.
Sure. Maryilyn was a history major at Ball State, and I've been to more museums in the past 5 or 6 years than I ever thought I would be. But I've developed a real love of history in the process. Really, it's great.
Now, JT, I do want to ask you about this. Now, you're an umpire also. Not many people know. Also, I do want to mention this real quick. You're also the voice for the Notre Dame band on Saturdays.
Right.
And then you also do the play-by-play in the ACC for the men's.
Actually, the public address announcement.
Public address,
PA.
Okay.
Right.
And then here's you doing the umpiring, and this is at, where is this at?
That, I believe, is at Washington High School a few years ago. Got into that. I never played baseball beyond Little League. I never even played in high school, but I always had a love of the game. And when I had a chance to get into officiating, I went to umpire school, trying to learn how to do it the right way, and it's been great. That's been about 15, 20 years or so.
All right. Well, I want to thank you guys both for coming on. As always, the time flies away from this, so we had so much more to talk to you guys about. But thank you very much,
great
JT,
fun,
for
Jason.
Having us on. Maryilyn,
thank you.
Thank you very much. And everybody get on out to the Center for History, because they just have a lot of great exhibits out there. And here we go back once again, and their newest CD, Kicking It, is now available. Is that correct, guys? Okay, and you can check out their website by going to our website at WNIT.org. It's Kalamazoo Kenny and the Rhythm Rats.
Michigan, and girl, I can't take you. Oh, no. Yes, I'm going to Detroit, Michigan. I gotta leave you behind. Gonna get me a job on the Cadillac assembly line. Saying yes about Mississippi Road. Oh, no! Yes, I'm tired of all that hooting and hollering. Oh, picking that nasty stuff. God, I had enough. Gonna take a train way up north. I won't have to keep saying yes, boss. Thank you. Michigan. And girl, I can't take you. Yes, I'm going to Detroit, Michigan. I gotta leave you behind. Ah, yes, I do. Gonna get me a job on the Cadillac assembly line. Yes, I'm going to Detroit, Michigan. Yes, I'm going to Detroit, Michigan. God, I'm headed to the Motor City. Oh, by way of Kalamazoo. Well, I'm down to Traverse City. Oh, over to the Friend Assembly. God, there's still been BH2.
Kenny and the Rhythm Rats. You want to check them out at the Firefighter Blues Festival this coming Saturday at the South Bend Airport, correct? All righty, and I think we're going to finish off our wedding reception rituals here tonight. You out there, Kels?
Yeah, we're still out here.
Partying.
Okay, and it looks like we got some new faces out there, it looks like.
Yeah, we got the young men out here. Okay. They're excited about this next part.
All right, and this is very typical at all wedding receptions. We have the wonderful garter toss.
Right, right.
So now that's my grandma sitting there, Kelsey.
I'll try not to be too fresh. Here,
that's
here,
right.
You
here
it.
We go. Grandma, hold the microphone.
Okay, let me see it here.
All right. This is something I never thought I'd see on TV. All right, and here we go. Then we got my grandpa down there.
I know who I'm throwing it to.
All right, ready? Here we go. It's the big garter toss for the finale tonight out there in the hallway.
You guys ready? You ready, Jason?
I'm all set.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
And there we go.
Oh, we have a winner. Somebody's lucky in love.
All right, great job out there, Kelsey, tonight. I know that was something that you've been wanting to do all year. So
oh, far. Yeah. Yep.
All right, well, that is the big show tonight. I'd like to thank all my guests, Dean Huppert from Fox 28 Sports, JT from JT in the Morning, and his wife, Maryilyn, from the Northern Indiana Center for History, and one more time for Kalamazoo Kenny and the Rhythm Rats. Thanks, guys, for coming on out. And just remember, when you're having a good day, that usually makes you feel pretty good. We'll see you next week, and have a good night, everybody.
Shift has been made possible by viewers like you. Thank you. You have been watching a WNIT local production.